Good morning children, welcome to today's class. Today's our topic is division by 10, 100 and 1000. If divisor is 10, last digit of the dividend, that is 1's place, gives the remainder, and other digits of the dividend give the quotient. Okay, let us check. Division by 10. We can take 24 divided by 10. 24 divided by 10. Here 24 is the dividend, 10 is the divisor. Then we know here we get the quotient is 10s in 24, 2. 2 is the quotient. 2 tens are 20. Then 4 is the remainder. Remainder 4. Clear? If divisor is 10, here the divisor is 10, last digit of the dividend, that means 1's place, last digit of the dividend gives the remainder. Last digit means here 4 is the last digit, that is the remainder. Clear? Then other digits of the dividend, gives the quotient. Other digits means here 2. 2 is the quotient and 4 is the remainder. It is dividing by 10. Okay, next division by 100. Check one example. 1623 divided by 100. Okay, here if the divisor is 100, the last two digit of the dividend, that means last two digit of the dividend means 23. It is the last two digits of the dividend gives the remainder. Then 23 is the remainder and other digits of the dividend gives the quotient. That means here the quotient, is 1623. We know here 1600. That means 16 hundreds are here. That means quotient is 16. Okay. Then 23 is the remainder. Remainder is 23. Okay. Next, we can check division by 1000. 48,378 divided by 1000. Here the quotient is, what is the quotient here? 1000 is the divisor. Then here how many thousands? 48,000. That means 48 is the quotient, correct? 48 is the quotient. Then the remaining last three digits are the remainder. Okay, the remainder is 378. Clear? Okay, it's very easy. Then children, this is our today's topic. In your textbook, page number 149, some works are related with these three topics. Okay, you have to complete it. Thank you.